The bum on the rods is hunted down as an enemy of mankind. The other is driven around to his club, is feted, wined, and dined. And they who curse the bum on the rods as the essence of all that's bad will greet the other with a winning smile and extend the hand so glad. The bum on the rods is a social flea who gets an occasional bite. The bum on the plush is a social leech, blood-sucking day and night. The bum on the rods is a load so light that his weight we scarcely feel, but it takes the labor of dozens of folks to furnish the other a meal. As long as we sanction the bum on the plush, the other will always be there. But rid ourselves of the bum on the plush and the other will disappear. Then make an intelligent, organized kick. Get rid of the weights that crush. Don't worry about the bum on the rods. Get rid of the bum on the plush. Oh, why don't you work like other folks do? How can I get a job when you're holding down two? Hallelujah, I'm a bum. Hallelujah, bum again. Hallelujah, give us a handout to revive us again. Oh, I went to a house and I knocked on the door. The lady said, "Scram bum, you've been here before." Hallelujah, I'm a bum. Hallelujah, bum again. Hallelujah, give us a handout to revive us again. Yeah, I went to that house and I asked for some bread. The lady said, "Scram bum, the baker is dead." Hallelujah, I'm a bum. Hallelujah, bum again. Hallelujah, give us a handout to revive us again. There I am in Spookaloo, city of magic, city of light, ensconced upon my front porch in broad daylight, long about noon, my rising time, drinking something of a potable beverage, playing my guitar, long after everybody else in the neighborhood has packed up their lunchbox and gone off down to Kaiser Aluminum to put in their shift. This enrages my neighbors. One in particular across the road, little retired banker fella, been known to cannonball his rotundity across the road and stand there and publicly berate me for my sloth and indolence. "Why don't you get a job," he says. Some of you heard that, I'll bet. Now me being hip to the Socratic method fires back a question. Why? "Why," he says, taken aback, "if you had a job, you could make $3, $4, or $5 an hour." I said, "Why?" pursuing the same tack. Said, "Hell, you make $3, $4, or $5 an hour. You could have a savings account. Save up some of that money." I said, "Why?" He said, "Well, you save up enough of that money, young fella. Pretty soon, you never have to work another day in your life." I said, "Hell, that's what I'm doing right now." Oh, I like my boss, he's a good friend of mine. That's why I'm starving out on the bread line. Hallelujah, I'm a bum. Hallelujah, bum again. Hallelujah, give us a handout to revive us again. Yeah, and I like Jim Hill, he's a good friend of mine. Say, that's why I'm booming down Jim Hill's main line. Hallelujah, I'm a bum. Hallelujah, bum again. Hallelujah, give us a handout to revive us again. I guess pretty soon I'll be headed back to Spokane, take up my task of wintering in, and I do a little light farming or heavy gardening, whichever. You know, that kind of farming is hard if you're in this traveling profession, and of course when you sing like I do, you got to be ready to travel with considerable alacrity. I got a Greyhound bus ticket in my back pocket all the time. But you see, quite often I'm not back in town in time for my plowing or my planting. That's awful. Now, one time I was sharing a platform in New York City, it was, with a bunch of high-powered labor politicos. It was a benefit for the farm workers, that's what it was. I remember Richard Chavez, Cesar's brother, was there. And so was Bella Abzug, former congresswoman from the state of New York. Remember her? Wonderful woman. I mean, she was loud, vociferous. Big hats. She was yelling at that audience, righteous beef it was, about how the feds, the FBI, had been opening her mail for ever so long. Well, I knew the feds had been opening my mail for at least 20 years, reading all my personal radical mail, and it never bothered me because I figured them birds had to learn that stuff somewhere, and it might as well be from my mail. But then it occurred to me, in my predicament, having the FBI open your mail might come in handy. I sent Sheila, my partner, a letter through the United States mail, and I said in it, "For God's sake, don't plow up the backyard. That's where the guns are buried." National Guard rolled up, dug up the whole backyard in time for me to come back and plant the damn thing. Oh, I went to a bar and I asked for a drink. He gave me a glass and he showed me the thing. Hallelujah, I'm a bum. Hallelujah, bum again. Hallelujah, give us a handout to revive us again. Whenever I get all the money I earn, the boss will be broke and to work he must turn. Hallelujah, I'm a bum. Hallelujah, bum again. Hallelujah, give us a handout to revive us again. And why don't you save all the money you earn? If I didn't eat, I'd have money to burn. Hallelujah, I'm a bum.